What's going on, guys? It's been a long time since I've thrown a video out. Way too long. And I figured it was more than enough time to do so. So we're gonna do it in style here. We've got the T800. A little bit different than how I'd normally do her up, but I like the fact that it's got LEDs, it's got two killer Jake brakes in it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start out with finding a load here. See where we can go from. I think we're in Portland. That we are. Well, let's see, you know, Sacramento. Really don't want to do these heavy hauls. But looking at everything in the freight market, my best chance is probably to go to Sacramento with this C-Can and figure out our intermodal car, sorry. We'll take that one and see where we can go. What's up, Eric? Long time no see. The latest version of OBS kind of screwed up all my settings. It's got the latency set way too far. So there's a delay between me seeing things and saying things, not because I'm slow or special. It's just the OBS keeps changing things up. I do love this Jake though. Sounds even better on the outside. Pick up our trailer. Even though we're still 50 miles out. No idea when the release date for Washington is. I'm looking forward to it. They keep releasing all these trailers, so I'm guessing it's gonna be sooner than we think, but I don't know. We got a bet going. What's gonna come out first? The Pro 4 and Pro 2 stadium trucks on iRacing or Washington? I'm going with Pro 2 and the Pro 4s, seeing how they will get out in the June build. Washington? No idea. We know it took them longer than expected to release Oregon, so it's probably gonna take longer than we thought to release Washington. Although, they should have most of the prefabs already done. Hey, get out of my way, dude. You're slowing me down. my main thing I've been doing. I've been focusing on road racing, getting ready for an upcoming season in a new league. So gotta get my shit straight and serious. The only thing that makes me think a little bit different is the fact that Washington can reuse a lot of the prefabs that are already here in Oregon. But it shouldn't be as bad. Quick when it's bobtailing, when it's got a load on it, it actually does bog down a little. Get our load here. There's our container. Where is it? Get the hell over here. Ah, it's on the back side. Frames are getting a lot higher because I'm only on a single screen. If I was on my running on triples, it's been a while since I've done this. I had to turn advanced coupling off because some of these trucks don't support it. Therefore, I can back up on a ridiculous angle like that and still connect. It's holding solid at 60 frames per second. Then again, I do probably have a way larger graphics card. Still isn't big enough for me. I need a larger card. Just not paying what they want for it. Changed over from running that full race rig to what I'm running now, which is basically just a 63 inch long heavy desk that I can bolt my wheelbase down to, got my monitors on, speakers, all that good junk. My Fanatec shifter, there's no place to mount it. So what I did is now for iRacing, instead of using the H shifter, I just paddle shift all the time. And rather than let a $200 shifter go to waste, I've got that SKRS 18 speed. I basically commandeered a broom handle, a metal broom handle, cut it to the size I wanted. There's a hole down in the bottom of the Fanatec shift rod, and there's a hole in the Lotus KRS. I just ran bolts through it. So I've got about a 2 foot extension. The shifter is bolted to the top of an old TV tray that I had set up before that was my keyboard holder when I had the 8020 rig. So it's bolted down to that so that doesn't move, and then the shift knob is bolted to one end of the bar and the other end is bolted to the actual shifter. So it gives me a realistic feeling when I'm throwing it through the gears. However, I'm still getting used to sitting in a computer chair. You got it. Can you do this? No, alright, I take it back. This thing hauls an ass regardless of what you're doing. What I was trying to emulate was like what it felt like when I was in a truck and had that long shifter extension running up from the floor, so it worked out pretty good. You definitely have to throw it over and to the right for 7th and 8th gear. Like full arm extension. That was nice. A couple little frame hits there. I've got 605 horsepower and 18 speeds. More than enough to get myself in trouble with. Every time I get a frame hit, it's weird because it says that the encoder is overloaded, which is bullshit because I'm on one screen. It's only whenever this game gets a frame hit. Holy shit, you cannot see anything in this truck. Well, hell, with the 18 speed, I skip gears in the low end. Five or 2, 4, 5. I think the balance of power on this one's just right. 75 miles an hour, just under 1500 RPM. Smooth sailing. I had to figure out what was causing the issues, and then I found out that it was just running on triples, but there were so many hours of Truckers MP I could have streamed. But I actually like running the triples on multiplayer. But it definitely, the OBS does not like it when it's on triples. I got a buddy, well, longtime friend, Seth, he loves the 10 speed. I can't understand why. I've gotta have at least a 13. Love this Jake break. Sometimes I'll just be driving along and I'll hit it and let it roll just for fun. Did not expect it when I saw this truck. I was like, oh, hey, this is the same T800 that was on ETS2. And earlier built the ATS, and it's back again. Not ready for the motor though. Well, the motor I always go with the M14, but I was not ready for the Jake brakes. Thank you. 1,000 pounds. They do. The low beams suck. Hey, dickhead. My low beams are garbage. Light mod in too, and still I've gotta run my freaking high beams, otherwise I can't see shit. Truck application, the only beacon. Really, dude? What the fuck was that checkup for? Get rolling, douche. See, I never got on ATS-2 to do this snow thing. I know they never incorporated it on ATS, which would have been cool, but of course, no, they had to give it only to ATS-2. I think it would have been could never get the damn thing to work then. It said it right in the, when I downloaded the mods, that it was just for ETS2. Yeah, you had two options. You could just put the snow part in, or you could add the physics too. The physics are what made it slippery as hell. That game in forever. I actually uninstalled it and went back to the original spin tires. It was such a disappointment. That should have just been a DLC for the original game, not a whole new game itself. That's how disappointing it was. Sometimes I use a controller, the majority of the time I use the wheel and pedals. I'm sitting so low I can barely see the freaking swan on the nose. Mods are just the base game. So I know the base game, the older one, used a lot higher poly textures than MudRunner. MudRunner was multi-platform. The original one was PC only. I don't know how the hell Cody's computer still runs iRacing and all that shit. It's a potato. So outdated, he still just keeps running it. And he can easily drive to Micro Center and buy a new computer. Then get rid of his goddamn G27. Section where I ended up getting a 5-day ban on MP because another truck forced me over on the other side of the interstate and I couldn't get back over for like 100 miles, and some flaming dipshit reported me even after I told him what happened, which apparently he didn't give a shit and neither did Trucker's MP when I appealed it. Stopped and exited out of the server and came back in. Like, what the fuck would that do? It would just put my truck back in the same exact position when they should have said just tow to service. Which is what I should have done in the first place, but the fact that they didn't even mention tow to service, just exit the server and come back in. Alright. Years and years and years I've been on that, in those servers, that's the first time I've ever gotten anything on me. Do you have a Micro Center close by? Micro Center. It's like a supermarket for computer stuff. Center close by, you can get a full-on built desktop for about $1,000 that's got a 1080, it's a TI in it. You can get a really, really, really good computer for about $1,000, $1,000 to $1,300, that you will not need to upgrade for a long time. sack. Jesus Christ. $6,000 a month. It's $18,000. Buy a fucking car with that. Actually, I could buy several cars with that. I was about to say, holy shit, dude. You're really gonna be spending that much money? Holy crap. Hell, if you're gonna make 18 grand, then you might as well invest in a good wheel, pedals, shifter, all that good shit, too, to go with the computer. Think about it, car. It's a red light. good. Didn't run it. Sacramento should have some good loads in it. I got a scraper going to Kansas. Well, I thought we would have good loads. Hey, look, it's the same exact trailer I just dropped off that's going back up the road to Montana. Don't think so. That's a long ass haul, and it's got me going up hills with that one. That's a good short hop over to Reno. Sholo. Damn, this is a little bit harder than I thought. Las Cruces, nothing. I haven't been to Ehrenberg yet. Screw it, let's go to Ehrenberg. What the hell? Something just interfered with my chrome and made it look like shit. Whoa, look at my chrome. It's like all rainbowy now. What the actual shit? That rainbow chrome, what the hell? Wasn't like that before. Guarantee I know what I need to do. I need to go in here. Get rid of the XL. Wasn't driving it anyways. I think the 387 was fine. But just to be safe, we'll ditch the 387. So that should fix that. See if I still have rainbow chrome. A lot of times I've noticed it's not that, it's trucks interfering with them. Other mods. What the hell? What is this shit? Now I got green chrome. Huh. That is actually hilarious. Okay, let's see. Let's restart Steam and see if it doesn't fix things. Steam. Where are you, shit? Exit Steam. And restart it. Yeah, that's fucking weird. I've never had Steam do that to me. Oh, go away. Yeah, well, that's lit. Loading back in. Bleed the lizard! Alright, my shit better not. Hey, it looks normal again. Perfect. See what happens when I get it back in it. Oh, magically the Chrome is fixed. Wait, where the hell did it put me? Did it put me back in Oregon? Son of a bitch, it put me all the way back in Portland again. Well, there's the tanker, but I don't want to take it all the way to Mississippi. Oh god, Rocky Mountain Doubles. You know what? Fuck it. I'll take these tires. Let's get ready to do 40 miles an hour. I'm still trying to do all the remaining achievements. I've got all the ones except for the heavy and specialized transport. And my fuel will get reset when I hook up to this load because they reset your hours and. Reset your hours, reset your fuel. being a douche and stepping out in front of me. Cop doing just sitting there. Alright, let's get this load out of the shipyard, which I don't know why the hell it'd be in the shipyard seeing how it's tires. Chrome up again. Damn it, Steve. Looks horrible. Absolutely horrible. I don't think it's steam. I think that's something else throwing a, that's something else that's throwing a conflict. Well, everything worked fine till today. Oh, it's unbearable. Fuck, I don't have one. Nice. I don't know if I can take driving for 179 miles with this shitty pixelated green garbage. God, oh god, all the textures are messed up. Sad is I'm watching OBS as to where it's at where I'm recording and where YouTube is at. I'm already on the highway. past the interchange. Probably about a 30-second delay. Governed at 40, but yeah. Apparently this tire load fits inside of a lane and doesn't require an escort. At least I can haul ass with it so we can fix this. Doesn't that bad from this view. Part of the haul truck thing. I know there's an achievement for hauling all the parts to a haul truck. I don't think I've done the bed. I've done the main chassis. I think I've already done these tires before. But you have to haul all the components to the gigantic dump truck and you get an achievement. But these are big ass mining truck tires. Tires aren't really that heavy. I mean, it's on a standard flatbed, so it can't be too heavy. Traffic here at all. Dude, there is one of the pallet trucks. Completely not doing his job. Some of these ones are broken when you throw in the coast-to-coast map. Unless this load does not require a pilot vehicle, but it's not stopping traffic like it should be. Thank you. on, guys. Speed up a little bit. Really, Dick, you stop and then... He's driving on the wrong side. Trailer, nothing about that achievement. So let's see, profiles. It should leave me in Portland, but I want to see the mod manager here. Where is the Kenworth at? Right there. Let's move it all the way up. I like the R-Series, we got the Cascadia. Let's run back through here and find the K100 under the... or the K108. That was the other truck I was looking for. Took a couple out. That was a classic XL. It's like down... It's down somewhere. There it is. Oh, I also have the 387 too. Shit, this is nothing compared to what I used to have. Alright, so let's move that down. Actually, let's move them down even further. Throw that one in, decrease the priority below. I swear to shit, if it puts me back in Portland again, I'm gonna be pissed. Which I have a feeling it's going to say, oh, your truck was parked in a safe spot. No, it wasn't. Oh, thank God it didn't do it. Alright, oh, the chrome is still all fucked up. I can see it from here. Well, it's mildly messed up. It's not as bad as it was. It's only mildly messed up. I can tolerate mildly messed up. Still looks kind of stupid. Okay, now it looks like it just fixed my shit. What the hell? What is going on with this game? Now the Chrome is all fixed. Until you get in there. What the shit is going on? I look at it from here, Chrome is perfect. Look at it in game, Chrome is jacked. And now it just fixed itself. Are you kidding me? Wow. Come on, guys, let me in. What the damn horn? Oh, God. I hit the guy so hard I knocked his trailers out of alignment. Did I knock his... Oh, it's just... Yeah, sorry about that, buddy. Didn't mean to hit you that hard. Must have updated today then, just like yesterday I was playing, no problems. Today is the first day I've ever dealt with these texture issues. Yes, we see like 2 miles an hour over a freaking bridge, even though it is pretty cool looking over here. I think it appears to be better. Let's check. No, it's still got like the weird carbon fiber chrome look, but it's still better than what it was. Sorry, I didn't blast ass through the intersection like that. White. Freight market. What are we taking? Steel coil. Is there not? What's the option? I can change the nothing on it. What the shit's the difference? They're all the same. And now my crown's all jacked up again. So do we go in here and then back out? And out. Oh god. This is gonna annoy as crap. All messed up. God, that's hideous. Can't take looking at it. But instead, it's just stupid. It's like something is causing a prism effect. My question is, why the hell did I steal the oil here? It's working just fine there, but it's throwing an error. So let's go back to Mod Manager. Uh-oh. That's not good. It's kind of frozen right now. Yep, it's non-responsive. Look at that. Well, let's relaunch again. Apparently I did break it. I will admit, I broke it. Holy shit, I must have really broke it. Nope, we're good. Yeah, I wish there was something I could do to get rid of that stupid ass, Let's get rid of the XL, get rid of the 387, get rid of the K108, get rid of the Anthem. I guarantee you it's Cecil's Mega Pack probably screwing with it. It's the only thing I could think. Because until I added that, because it's tuning parts and interiors, I guarantee you it was a conflict with Cecil's Megapack. No, I bet you I just figured it out. I hope. I'm not 100% sure, but I think it's Cecil's Megapack throwing a, well, in Farming Sim, an LUA error, but I think it's throwing a texture error. Please, for the love of God. Oh, God damn it. Where did it put me? I guess Portland again? Yep. Yep, look at that. Loads are fixed. Ooh, a transformer. Nice. And that's only going to Spokane? I'm hauling that. That's what it was. It was Cecil's Mega Pack. Fucking knew it. It always does that. Yep, everything is all fixed now. Should have known. Left all the other trucks in and been fine. It was just the Mega Pack. course, I'm fully ready to eat my words if it still does it. But I'm pretty sure it was the mega pack that did the errors. I'm tired of getting reset to Portland. That game right there is an absolute frame killer. And I would stay away from it for a while. With it still being early access, it is still extremely buggy. And it's extremely weird still. I mean, it's not like it's a bad game, it's just, with it still being in early access, it's got a ton of glitches and bugs, and it's just to do simple things, it's complicated. Like, you can't just grab a gun and shoot somebody. You gotta find the gun, you gotta find the right magazine, you gotta find a box of ammo for it. You have to load the ammo every time, so you have to go into your inventory, take ammo out of a box, load the magazine of the gun you're wanting to fire, insert the magazine into the gun, then reload it. It's a pain. They were supposed to have added cars and stuff to it, but you get thrown into a car. Plus, if you die, you get spawned, like, randomly wherever, whatever quadrant they feel like putting you in. You've got to maintain a positive prisoner status, otherwise your the little thing on the back of your neck will start glowing red. Man, it's fun to play, but it's one of those games that's fun to play for like an hour. Recently, so I couldn't tell you if it's gotten any better. Eat that. I think Mike and Cody are playing it, and they said it was still pretty broken. What am I picking up here? This big ass freaking stop this one. Have a boat anchor on a trailer here. Come on, pig, get up there. You got two more gears to go. Got this. Yes, I got it. How heavy am I? I had to get 170,000 pounds or 100 something pounds, whatever. That was one of the achievements I was working for. Got it now. Now all the rest of them are just going to be, Oh, the damn thing doesn't stop. Now the only achievements left are all special transport. 2,000 that guy just totally cut off the semi. Oh, I am. I'm glad I hit that way station though. If I can pass this dude before I start slowing down. Yeah, the rumble strip. Yes, it is. Cabbage Hill. stop on a fucking dime. Why the hell are you flagging me? I've already been fucking weighed. I think it's just gonna make me stop at your weigh station because it's being racist against my truck. It knows I've gotta shift gears like 8,000 times. Trucks that get the drive by are Peterbilts. It was flagging all of us Kenworths. Not fair. Now what's strange is I actually set this truck up for heavy haul and still not doing what I want it to do. Volvos. It's everything. Because it keeps saying encoder overloaded, which is stupid because it's not. I'm literally using less than 5% of my CPU. Nope, Chrome is fine. I got that one locked down. Got rid of Cecil's mega pack and it won't be a problem anymore. He used to do that way back in the day when I still ran Vipers 389 before he stopped updating it. have to blind everybody because I can't see shit in all the beams. Not that bad, not that bad with the low beams on. Gotta be perfect, I gotta hit everything. Can't just hit one or two things, you gotta hit everything. Big time stutter there. Thank you. Vacuum it out. Oh, I could easily make one. And every time I hit something, it says fatality. But let's see, 2 hours in, I'm hungry. I think that was a successful first trip we know, or first video back in a long time we know. Things still haven't changed. I still run over everything. Blatant disregard for any speed, traffic collisions, any of that good shit. But try and be on a lot more than I have been. Although there might still be a lot of iRacing popping up in between, especially with the new season with Audubon coming out. But as always, thank you guys for watching, and we will see you next time.